Hey, no, I wasn't doing anything. Just finishing up a video, really. Definitely, for sure. Thinking of a topic for the next one, actually, as a matter of fact. I'm certainly got a new one coming out very soon, but I just can't think of a new one to make. So, you know what? Let's see if there's anything new that happened that has happened recently. I haven't really taken a look at the news in the video game industry recently, so let's take a look. All right. Video game news. Okay, well, the highlights don't seem very interesting, so let's just take a little scroll here. Israeli game company, something about, I don't know. Lucasfilm Ubisoft announced open world Star Wars video game. Now that's interesting. Okay. Well, let's Lucasfilm. Are they? Is that new? Did they reintroduce Lucasfilm? Or LucasArts or whatever? Let's see. Let's keep scrolling. There's another thing about the Ubisoft. Oh, more Star Wars open world. Okay. Makes sense. I mean, Star Wars is a pretty big game series, or like a game capability. So, wait a minute. What is this? Indiana Jones from the fifth chapter to the new video game? Wait. You're kidding. Hold on. This is not video. Oh. Essential video game adventures. While fans wait for Bethesda's new entry in the Indiana Jones video game canon? Hold on a second. Pulling my leg, right? There's no way. Okay, so, yes, if you haven't heard already, Indiana Jones is getting a new video game. And that is what we call a big win. Now, first things first, Lucasfilm Games, it's back. Originally formed in the early 80s by George Lucas, had games like The Secret of Monkey Island, I think probably the like Indiana Jones point-and-click adventure games as well. I've never played any of those, but those are some probably more famous ones. There's also two more listed right here. It was rebranded to LucasArts in 1990, and it was shuttered in 2013 after Disney acquired Lucasfilm. Now it's back, and we've got two new games. Open world Star Wars game by Ubisoft, and now Bethesda will be publishing an Indiana Jones game. So, what does all this mean? Firstly, just to note, again, it is not being developed by Bethesda Game Studios, which is responsible for the likes of Fallout, Fallout 76, and Skyrim. It's being published by Bethesda Softworks, which is a publishing studio, not a development studio. It is being developed by Machine Games. Who is Machine Games, you ask? Well, they're responsible for titles like this and this. So, they definitely have a little bit of expertise on the matter of punching Nazis in the face. Now, Todd Howard, who is, believe it or not, a big Indiana Jones fan, is going to be the executive producer. So, hopefully, that means that we will be seeing some really due diligence, I guess, or due justice given to the game and the character involved. Todd Howard, by the way, in case you guys didn't know, was the or is the kind of face of Fallout and the Skyrim series, or Elder Scrolls, I should say. And he, I guess, was just kind of able to re-release Skyrim pretty much, I don't know, every year on new platforms that came out, just no matter what. Skyrim VR. Skyrim on an Amazon Alexa. and I believe probably PS5 and Xbox One X, etc., etc. I don't know how he does it. The game's 9 years old, and he still finds a way to re-release it on technology that's basically from the space age compared to the game. Pretty impressive, I'd say. So I think it's kind of in good hands. And also, just to note, Todd Howard is not exactly responsible for the kind of disaster of Fallout 76, at least as far as I know and read, besides the fact that maybe he, you know, is kind of responsible for the hype and stuff like that, kind of describing the game, I guess. But that's not the point. He is an Indiana Jones fan, and hopefully he will be able to lead the game in a good direction. So, I haven't even discussed what we actually know, which is not exactly a lot. There was a 26-second teaser trailer, which I shall play momentarily. And that's it. Alright, so not a lot, right? That's what you think. Now, hidden throughout, there's quite a bit of hidden Easter eggs and such. So, at the beginning, there's not really anything that tells us much about the game. We've got some books here. Todd Howard made one of them. They're not real books, but they certainly look very cool. We've got Forbidden Stones, Myths That Made Us, I believe, Ancient Circle or Ancient Circles, and here is a coffee cup, or mug I should say, with the crest of what people would assume to be Marshall College, which would make sense given the setup, I guess. And oh yes, of course, so right here we have this thing, which made an appearance in Raiders of the Lost Ark at the very beginning, the golden fertility idol that Indiana Jones takes from the temple, gets multiple people killed, pretty much. Well, indirectly. One of them gets killed by the natives in the area, and one of them dies to a trap because he's crazy and he's trying to steal the idol. But that's beside the point. And that says Ziggurat Clue. A ziggurat, if I remember, is people have said is stuff to do with Mesopotamia, and kind of like a pyramid, but in Mesopotamia style, or something along those lines. Here's the like a diary, and we have a passport here, stamped by Bethesda Softworks, I should say. And right here we have a map that says we have Belvedere and Sistine Chapel. That is the Vatican City, and it's solidified by the fact that that says Rome on there, if you could not tell. And then we also have one. Oh my goodness, this isn't even on HD. What the heck? Oh. That's because that's the best we got. That says October something, 1937, as far as I've heard, which is in between the first and the third movies. So that means kind of like the height of his career, as people have said, or as Bethesda has said themselves. We then get a typewriter here saying Machine Games, and we already know what that is. And then we have Lucasfilm Games. A nice little, very old camera with some old film, and a picture of what appears to be some kind of ruins, and there is the fedora and the whip, and of course, we have his famous revolver, which has changed on multiple occasions. In the third movie, had a Webley of some kind, not an actual, like, original Webley, but like a variant, I believe. He's had a 1917, oh, I just realized you can't see that. Oh well. You saw it beforehand, but so you'll know. And then, boom. Now, when I first watched this, I will say, actually, no. Every time I've watched it, pretty much, it has given me chills when it starts playing the opening notes. Very nice. Okay. So, that is that. Now, other than the general setting and some various smaller pieces, we don't have much to go on. So, speculation. Let's do that. That might be fun. So, kind of what I think would be at least kind of necessary in any Indiana Jones game, right? I'm a big fan of the franchise of movies, and I've played quite a few Indiana Jones game. the best one definitely being this one, followed closely by this one. I kind of have a general idea of what would be nice in an Indiana Jones game, or at least what I would believe, right? I'm not an expert. This is just my personal opinion. You guys can have your own opinion, but here are my ideas, right? Firstly, good melee system. It can't be a button masher, all right? Indiana Jones has a lot of hand-to-hand combat in the movies. He doesn't use his pistol a lot, and when he does, it's very short, and there's not a massive gunfight, except for that one scene in Raiders of the Lost Ark. But, anyways, that's beside the point. We're talking about melee. It needs to be unique. It needs to feel rewarding, all right? When you take down an enemy, or just the combat itself, it needs to feel like it's rewarding, or that it's unique and fun to engage in, right? Maybe utilizing your environment. Staff of Kings did that a little bit, but on the Wii, it can't be a button masher. I don't know if I've already said that. Because if you just mash buttons, it's pretty much easy, and it's not going to feel rewarding, and it's going to feel... Melee combat in an Indiana Jones movie is very, very important, because most of the time, he will be doing a lot of fisticuffs and utilizing his environment to take down his enemies. And sometimes he'll face stronger enemies, so you need to find different ways to deal with that. And that's one of the more important things to think of when you're making an Indiana Jones game, in my opinion. Using your whip also has to feel rewarding for certain things. Like what? I'm not entirely certain. Doing puzzles in like the Lego Indiana Jones games had a lot of whip usage in puzzles, so maybe something along those lines, but using it in combat is another thing, to disarm enemies, which was done in the Staff of Kings, or, you know, stuff along those lines. And, yeah, so overall, combat just needs to be rewarding, feels like it's, you know, not clunky or anything, not a button masher, unique, etc., etc. And I'm trying to keep this short because I'm already going over like 11 minutes. Second thing, real quick, is the story. Really need to focus on story. It's a story-based game because it's based on movies, and that movies always tell a story. Characters need to feel engaging. Cutscenes need to feel, you know, good. And the story itself shouldn't be disjointed, kind of like the Staff of Kings on the non-PSP versions and stuff. And so maybe old characters can come back from, like, Raiders of the Lost Ark, or, you know, even new characters, anything that kind of helps create the original story that Machine Games is working on. And a real quick third is good puzzles. It needs to feel challenging, but not so challenging that you're ready to quit the game after, like, 40 minutes of not being able to do it. You can't be frustrated by the puzzles, but you need to make... It still needs to feel challenging enough so that it's not like, oh, this is way too easy, you know? So if they're going to have puzzles in any regard, kind of like, you know, in The Last Crusade with Temple's Traps, you know, the Word of God, the Path of God, Penitent Man Will Pass, etc., etc., and then choosing the right cup, those are all puzzles. They may be more obvious because the character kind of, you kind of know already, sort of, I guess. But yes, and real quickly again, gameplay needs to be unique. It can't feel like the games that have come as a result of the movies. So it can't be too close to feeling like Tomb Raider, and it can't feel too close to feeling like Uncharted. Those are all inspired by Indiana Jones, but having gameplay from them doesn't make it feel original. It just makes it feel like a kind of reskin of those games, you know. And so it needs to be unique. There needs to be gameplay elements that you probably, you know, you don't see in Tomb Raider or Uncharted. You can have things similar to them. You just can't have them be what feeling like they're ripped straight out. So obviously whip mechanics. We don't have whips in the whip in Tomb Raider, or I don't think Uncharted. I wouldn't. No, maybe like a certain form, but there are other things you can do, right? Less gunplay-centric gameplay is another unique thing to Indiana Jones. He doesn't use his gun as much, and usually you're not taking down too many people trying to use it, because you don't really have a place to store any extra real ammo. So having a melee-centric gameplay is also unique to it in that setup, But also, you have plenty of other things you can try probably pick out. I'm not the best at just thinking of these on the spot, but I'm just going, with what comes to mind. Another unique thing to Indiana Jones is kind of the cool chase scenes that he gets caught up in. So, desert chase, so when he's chasing the Ark in the truck, so you have the horseback catching up to the trucks, and even the tank chase or the motorcycle chase from The Last Crusade. So, trying to implement something along those lines, some cool chase mechanics for certain things, either in a preset level. Ooh, I just messed that up. Either preset level as a part of the story, or if it goes open world, which I wouldn't expect to happen because Indiana Jones is kind of a linear storyline, but they are making an open world Star Wars, which I feel like is kind of easier to do. But if they do go open world, having kind of like convoys that you can track down, or if you do like a quest or something that ends up the kind of people that you're fighting end up are trying to take it on this certain mode of transportation or trying to search for it using a convoy. You can some kind of some kind of requirements to destroy them or stop them or whatever could be pretty interesting, I think. And there's plenty of other different things that you can think of or that they could think of that I can't think of, other people might not think of. It's, because it's up to them. I'm not working for them. But time will only tell, and so it's really up to them to see where the game really goes. But I'm gonna try and stop this here. And so, if you didn't like the video, please leave a like down below. Maybe leave a comment or subscribe. If you didn't enjoy, I guess you can leave a dislike, but I sincerely hope you guys enjoyed. And until the next time, I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.